Why, good evening, fellow podcast listeners. Welcome back to the BurtnBurger podcast. I am one of your hosts, Burger, and with me today, as always, is my awesome, sexy, and gorgeous cousin, Bert. Bert, how is it today? How is it? Is it good?
I'm not too bad. Yeah, I mean, it's been pretty stressful week with classes and all that, but we can get into that later, of course. How have you been?
I've had a pretty laid-back week, to be honest. Just been playing a lot of fucking Xbox and taking it easy, I guess. So, pretty much the complete opposite of what you're doing.
Yeah, it's sounds like my usual, though. So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, no, that's the difference between a graduate student and an undergraduate student, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm getting pretty screwed over in my classes.
Yeah, well, I tell you what, man, I think it's that stupid fucking school that you go to, because I had an ex-girlfriend go there, too, and when she talked about it, I was just like, "That you guys are just making things, like, hard on purpose just to be cunts."
Yeah, like I have a class that goes until 9 o'clock at night, so that's fun.
Yeah.
But like, yeah, 3-hour classes and all that isn't super fun. I know yours are pretty crazy, but.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the norm here, but mine's, I don't know. I mean, I've been going to school for so long now, I don't even fucking care, but. Like you were telling me, like, because I was trying to drop some fire deets about the podcast to you, and you weren't opening the messages, you weren't responding. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? And finally texted me like 17 hours later, and you're like, I'm in class, fuck weed, I can't have my phone out, it counts as an absent.
Yeah, a lot of the, it's so, I don't know, it's like they don't really treat us like we're adults, you know? It's like, I get the whole, like, you know, it's distracting and all that, you know, the teacher's trying to teach and then they see you on your phone or whatever, but that seems kind of like a weird ADD tick that they can't focus and see somebody looking down at the same time. Like,
yeah. Yeah. And it just pisses me off that that's a rule in college. Like, seriously, we're paying thousands upon thousands of dollars to go here, and you're going to get bitchy at me because I choose to look at my phone instead of look at you. Like, it's my fucking money. If I want to go over and come in the corner, as long as I'm not distracting anybody, I should be able to do it, right?
Yeah, as long as I'm quiet.
You know? Yeah. Yeah, no, I don't know. All I know is that school is fucking stupid, so you should just drop out and be a whore like I know you want to be.
Yeah, see, maybe I could actually hit up Uncle Scott for that Walmart job he was offering you.
Yeah, put him down as a letter of reference or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, I was thinking about that. We never actually brought up Uncle Scott at all last week. Like, we didn't even utter his name.
Yeah, I was thinking about that, too, when I went and listened to the episode, because that's what I like to do, listen to my own voice and just stroke my 9-incher to it.
Yeah, I ended up doing that, too, because of all the name drops last week. But
Yeah, no, I haven't heard from Scotty in a while. He'll go like that, where he'll text me multiple times every day on a weekly basis, and then he'll just go months without talking to me because he forgets to pay his phone bill or something like that. So, yeah, I think he's on the low side of things now. But he'll be back. Don't worry.
Good, good. Yeah, we'll definitely have to, well, I guess we're probably not going to schedule or meet anytime soon, but yeah.
Yeah, no, that probably won't happen until I graduate and I'm back home for a little bit. So, but anyways, to all of you guys that are watching us on YouTube, you might notice something a little bit different about this video. Bert, you want to tell them what they're seeing right now?
Oh yeah, so we decided a couple weeks ago, well, I guess Burger here, I remembered it this time.
There you go, proud of you. You had to pause Burger and here. Really say it nice and slow.
Like, wait a second. Yeah. No, so so Burger mentioned a couple weeks ago that we watched this other podcast, the official podcast. We bring it up every once in a while, but they actually have these things called audiograms, which are kind of like the waveforms, and each person has them next to their name and everything, and it kind of gives you more of a visual when you're watching it. It seems pretty cool, though. Yeah, so we're going to put that in this episode. Should be a very fun addition to the show.
Yeah, exactly. And with this big budget that we have, you know, we can bring things like this to you. So if you guys want to keep seeing cool things, like maybe you'll see our cocks in the corner someday, you can donate to our Patreon. That doesn't fucking exist.
Yeah.
Someday. I think once we get over the 2-subscriber mark, maybe we'll start thinking about a Patreon. But my one fucking bitch-ass friend will not sub, and neither were yours. You said the dude loves listening to the show, and my friend said he really enjoys it too, and here they are just fucking taking our content for free and not supporting the creators at all.
I know, it's screwed up.
This is what it must be. This is what it feels like to be Markiplier.
Yeah? Why is that?
Just because, you know, like, the famous content creator and they don't get the credit or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
To their work. So we're basically up there with PewDiePie now, so.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I can get behind that.
Yeah. No, but, yeah, I just, the audiograms thing, I thought would be a nice little addition to the show, and Bert is a little bit of a tech whiz, so he said he'd be able to do it, and from my understanding, it's a pretty simple thing, so.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we just kind of wanted to throw that in there, and we're working on getting some art for this channel, too. Bert is the one that designed the beautiful logo that you guys see in every episode.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, so now we kind of want to open up the floor to our listeners or to anybody that is more talented than Bert, which is pretty fucking difficult because Bert's like Picasso, you know, but...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
as our beautiful burger can tell you. But, yeah, so to those of you that don't know who we are, we would like you guys to just listen to the show and really listen to our beautiful, sexy voices and our classic undertones or whatever the fuck that means. Oh, yeah. And get an image in your head on what we look like and draw that image and try to make it look a little cartoony because I think that would be kind of dope with the theme and what we're trying to do here. But I'm kind of interested to see what you guys can come up with. So go ahead and start drawing some shit for us, and you can send it to us through our email at BurtnBurger@gmail.com. I know, I'm pretty fucking classic. Or you can find us on Twitter at BurtnBurger, and you can DM us over there as well. And then also you could text Bert at... I'm just expecting your ass cheeks just to start closing there. Yeah. What are you fucking doing?
Like, where's this going?
I just hear the Discord disconnect button.
Yeah.
Not doing this anymore.
Nope.
But yeah, no, send us your shit. We'd like to see what you guys can come up with. Draw anything you want. If you want to draw Bert with a big cock for a nose, go right ahead. Doesn't matter. Yeah. And if you want to make me look like I have a 12-pack and a 9-incher, go right ahead. So,
yeah, full artistic liberties.
Yep. Yeah, do whatever the hell you want. So, but yeah, so sub to us on this goddamn channel, please. I know there's more than two people that listen to this show. So give us a sub on YouTube and check us out on Twitter. Again, that's just BurtnBurger. Give us some followers. We have one follower right now, and it's a bot. So
good old porn bots.
Yeah, we had two, but that bot got banned, so you know. God rest her soul. So you know, when it comes to those bots, like, I wonder what it'd feel like. Can you imagine, like, being on the internet and all of a sudden you see you, like, you're like, what?
Yeah,
because
they probably just rip those pictures offline.
Oh yeah, there's no way they ask.
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, can we use this for the sex ad?
It's like,
I saw one where it said, like, it was some porn ad, and it was on iFunny. I didn't see it myself, you know, but, it was like, hey, are you ugly? And it showed this picture of this gross looking man, and this guy, like, screenshotted it and uploaded it and said, that's my fucking picture.
Oh, no. Oh, that's terrible. Gosh.
Some guy, I think this might have been a different one, but he's like, what the hell were you doing on a porn site? And the guy's like, looking up a recipe for oatmeal raisin cookies. What the fuck do you think I was doing?
Oh, that's awesome. I love those things when you see, like, the people posting totally normal videos to Pornhub or whatever. You know,
I like the complete opposite. It's the opposite where it's porn, but then the comments are totally normal. Like, hey, how do I find this this spot in Fallout 4? And one guy just comments just totally normal, like that's on YouTube or something.
I wonder if it's somebody, you know, who's done with the video and then they're just kind of like, well, let's go bond with some fellow degenerates.
Yeah, no, seriously, that's where we should be advertising, because like porn or not, that shit gets a lot of traffic.
It does. It's insane.
I know. I'll see like this one porn. It wasn't that good or anything like that. It's about 6 minutes long. It was blurry. It has 8 million views.
Mm-hmm.
And here we are with 2 subs. We can't get our 2 friends to fucking sub.
I know.
Oh, my goodness. I'm about ready to say to my friend and to your friend that listens to this, don't fucking worry about it anymore. Seriously, if it's that fucking difficult for you, then just don't worry about it. I'm done begging.
Yeah, what the heck?
Yeah, bunch of cunts is what you guys are. Yeah, my one buddy will just... I have 2 good friends that really listen to it. One loves our show. I feel like we could go and autograph something for him and he'd hang it up and everything like that. Such a sweet guy. And then my other friend just constantly tells me how shitty it is, how fucking cringy it is and all this stuff. But, you know, he listens every week, so.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. It actually, it sounds like him. Mm-hmm. Such a fucking dickhead.
Yeah, how's it feel to talk mean about somebody, Bert? You like that shit?
Well, after he ruined our heists, like, spent a whole 3 hours just getting killed over and over again in GTA, you know?
Yeah.
I feel justified.
Yeah. I don't know what's happening right now.
Yeah? Is it Shitternet?
No, but your brother just texted me, so what is the podcast?
Oh. That's awkward. I never told him. I don't trust him because he, like, hangs out with these like people from Hawaii and all these other degenerates and stuff, and they just kind of stay up until 6 a.m. on the weekdays, like, and they go to school still. They're like 14 or something, and they stay up so fucking late just like playing Minecraft and talking to each other and shit. It's insane. But yeah, no.
That's why you don't trust him?
Well, I trust my brother a lot. Like we're pretty tight, but mm-hmm. But, like, his friends are so fucked. And he would probably eventually end up slipping up, so I can't tell him about it. Like, I don't give a shit about the content.
Yeah, I don't know. He literally just hit me up. He's like, so, what is the podcast?
Yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. I almost said it again. Yeah, he's a piece of shit.
Yeah, no, that's... I don't trust him. I'd really trust you.
Yeah, I know. I'm bound to fuck it up eventually, but...
But yeah, I don't know where we're going, but what do your friends think about the show so far?
Well, one of them I'm pretty sure is a psychopath, and he said that he liked the idea, but he doesn't have the patience to listen to me for more than 15 minutes at a time. So I can understand that. But the other one said he likes it, and every time I'm like, hey, you should like totally sub, he's like, yeah, and then never actually does it. So right now he's probably, you know, blushing a little bit.
Yeah, he's like twirling his finger in his hair and everything like that.
Shit. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, no. So a big way that I advertise this thing is through my iFunny channel.
Uh-huh.
So that is because I run this WTF fun fact page, and I've been running it for years now, and it's over the years it's gotten over 4,000 subscribers, and it's gotten 2 features so far, so that's pretty exciting. Like, the combined likes on both pictures is like 100k and thousands of comments and shit, so it's got an audience behind it. And also, nobody knows who I am over there because I just post You know what I mean? I just repost facts that I find on the internet. So
it's kind of a weird niche. I never really asked you how you got into it, but
yeah, no, I don't. Oh gosh, I've had that account for years. How do you say that?
For years.
Yeah. Yeah. Years. And I don't know. I think what it was is I was trying to build a YouTube channel, and I was like, okay, well, I know people like to read these. There's a website where they update these facts daily, so I'll just take them off of this website and upload them here. And once I get to a certain amount of subs, then I'll start advertising myself on there, and I just never got around to it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so, yeah, and it just, it's, well, there she is again. Should we give it a name?
Bessie.
Bessie, what a fucking faggot. That you couldn't get more generic. It needs to be something like Earl or something.
Never mind. I was going to say Daquan.
Daquan, nice. Sense. Well, we just lost all of every sponsorship.
Mm-hmm.
Good job. No, but anyway, so yeah, that's where we can advertise this podcast is on iFunny because no personal affiliation. I am there.
Yeah.
No, so if I can't like go on my Facebook and tell my grandma and you know, be like, yo, you should watch this Grams and shit. So, so yeah, this is something that we're doing just for fun. So if you could like the vids that you watch, if you could subscribe and, you know, you can tell your friends about it and, you know, hopefully we can
The more get you it guys, somewhere. Show interest in it, the more we can add to it, you know? I mean, you guys didn't really earn the audiograms thing. We're just doing that out of generosity, but we could do stuff like that in the future.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, Jesus tells us to forgive our debtors, so these audiograms are, you know, because of Jesus, so the next one might not be free, guys.
Yeah. Yeah, no, you guys are fucked.
Yeah, so for sure, make sure you sub, like, and follow us on Twitter, please. It's kind of sad just to see the one Twitter bot. You know, she's faithful, I will say that.
Yeah.
But, so, yeah, enjoy the audiograms. But there are some things that I really wanted to discuss today. So, I did some research, and I've done some playing. I've done some jerking off, and you know, all stuff the day's like that. Work. Yep, you know, typical day for Burger. And, boy, I you can probably cut this part out, but I like the little note that you put under TV shows. Twid. that's, I love how much you attribute to these fucking recording notes. But anyways.
Yeah, boy.
There you go. anyways, I've been playing a lot of Grand Theft Auto 5 lately. I know you went home over the weekend, so I wasn't able to play with my beautiful cousin, but
yeah, I know. It was rough.
I was able to hop on and shit because they recently did the $2 million.
Oh yeah.
You logged on from this week to this week and then from this week to this week, you got $1 million for each week, so
yeah, a little promo was always really nice.
Yeah, seriously, if any of you guys are Rockstar players, you need to go and subscribe to them on social media because they will just post shit like log on today and get a free 250K and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So
yeah, and Red Dead and GTA and all that jazz.
Yeah, exactly. So but yeah, so I went and I bought myself an Impressor Mark II. And that cost almost $4 million. And there's a couple things. So first of all, for those of you that don't know what that is, the Oppressor Mark II is the bike that flies in GTA.
Anybody who's played the game should know what it is.
Yeah, what kind of feelings does the Oppressor you know, facilitate in your gut there, Bert.
Pure hatred. Yeah, no, it was it's design of the devil.
Yeah. Yeah. The amount of gas that fucking thing gives you.
Literally try and do anything, and one determined motherfucker will end all of it.
Yeah, for sure. So I wanted to be one of those motherfuckers. Oh, long yeah. story yeah, short, of course. I wanted to be a griefer too. So I went and I saved up and I sold and I fucking sucked and fucked until I got one. Yeah. And I got it. And then I go to fly it. And yeah, there's no missiles on it. There's nothing. Oh, man. Yeah,
it's easily the worst part of that whole vehicle.
No, there is a part that's more. Yeah, there's a part that's more worse, and I'll get that to the minute. But I did some research before, and I knew the missiles weren't going to be there, and I knew the countermeasures weren't going to be there. And apparently, you have to have a terabyte. Yeah, terabyte's real life, right?
Yeah,
yeah, terabyte. Yeah, so it's a terabyte, terabyte. I don't fucking remember. It's that big goddamn semi thing that
you can do
a bunch of shit in the back. You have to buy one of those in order to edit it. And in order to buy that terabyte, you have to buy a nightclub. So you have to buy a $4 million bike, then you have to spend over $1 million to get a nightclub, and then you have to spend another $1 million on the fucking terabyte. And then on top of all of that shit, you have to spend like $125,000 to get missiles on the cocksucker.
God damn. I mean, it makes me feel a little better knowing that you really got to work for it. But, you know, if they made it too easy, then everybody would just be zipping around, fucking everybody's day up. But
gosh, I thought buying something for $4 million was hard enough.
No, it's pretty steep. But
yeah, no, seriously, I got to start grinding because there's a big sale going on, like nightclubs and stuff, so I can get one real cheap now. But
okay.
But yeah, no, that really pissed me off. So I was just sitting there and I was thinking, you know, is it really worth it to buy this thing? Cause I gotta buy all this other shit before I can actually really use it. It also has countermeasures on it. So when people shoot missiles at you, you can send out flares and stop the missiles. So it's really OP. It really is, but I wondered, like, is this thing even worth it? And so I clicked on it. And I thought it was going to say, are you sure you want to buy this? Nope, it just bought it. It just flat out bought it.
Oh, that's awesome. Like,
son of a bitch. And then I got on the thing, and I absolutely love it. It's fucking amazing. That thing is, like, the coolest thing in the game.
Oh, yeah.
I really think so.
You let me try it the other day, and it's like, dude, when you activate the boosters, you literally, like, it's neck snapping speeds.
Yeah.
Yeah, like you gotta be careful when you're aiming that fucker, because you're gonna get pancaked against the fucking building if you're not careful.
Yeah, no, seriously. And the thing I like about it is it's really easy to control. So there is no nook or cranny that is unexplorable now in GTA. Like, you can do anything with it. So it's really cool, and you can get from one side of the map to the other very
It has quickly. To be like at least 5 or I guess at most like 5 minutes. No, not even that. I don't know.
Yeah, the map is it's fucking huge,
but
she's quick, I will say really, that very so quick. It's definitely worth it now without all the weapons and stuff on it. So it comes with a little machine gun, I guess, if that means anything whatsoever.
Hell yeah.
I'd rather have balls in the back just flopping in the wind than a machine gun.
That machine gun is so useless in GTA. Like, anything that flies and has a machine gun on it, it's not even fucking worth it.
It's hard. It's hard to control that some bitch.
It is.
But yeah, so where was I going with this? Speaking of the weapons, yeah, it doesn't even need weapons. I don't know why Rockstar added it. Like, when I get my shit, I'll be happy they have it. But seriously, like, it would be such a cool vehicle to just fly in it and that's it. Like, I don't know why you can't just take your gun out and shoot your pistol or whatever.
Can,
like,
you actually do that? Or
nope, because you have the machine gun. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah, I can aim better with my pistol than I can with this stupid ass machine gun.
Yeah, because it like goes off of the front, It points with yep. the vehicle, so like you have to be flying downward at the person you're trying to shoot. It's like, okay, I'd have better chances yeah. of running into them.
Yeah, no, exactly. It's stupid, so I don't know. I do like it though. I would highly recommend it. It is a grind though, fellas. Oh, yeah. I'm not gonna lie, she's a grind, so all my friends bitch about it now because I get to the mission way faster than they do now.
Oh, it's insane.
I just sit there butt fingering myself while they talk about how fast my bike is. So. Yeah. Oh my goodness. So yeah, speaking of GTA, I did some research though, and I found the best way to make money. And I saw a couple different videos talk about this. So, I just kind of wanted to drop this out there, and if anybody has a better way of making some cash on GTA 5. Yeah, if you guys have any other ways of making money, let us know. But apparently, like, the most legit way without hacking or glitches or cheats or anything like that is to buy a fucking nightclub out of all places.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I know some of our friends have some. They seem, you know, I just love doing that weird crackhead dance, you know, where you just flail your arms around. But
yeah, because you can dance on the dance floor.
Oh, that's hilarious. Yeah.
But yeah, the number one way to make money to multiple people that I saw is with a nightclub. So let me tell you why. So the nightclub, this is a big organization where you can have people come in and they can party and drink and dance and all that shit, you know, like a fucking nightclub. And then there's like an underground warehouse with it or wherever it's at. But anyways, that warehouse is where the good shit happens. So what you can do is you can run other businesses outside or with the nightclub, I guess. So, for example, say you buy a motorcycle club in GTA. And from that, you bought like a cocaine factory and a meth lab and things like that. And say you have a bunker and you're doing weapons running from that. Each facility has its own money that it can make. And then you can also make money through that facility through the nightclub. So basically, you're constantly making material in your separate facilities, and you're making material completely separate in the nightclub. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So say you have 10 out of 10 bags of coke and you go and sell them through your coke factory or your coke factory.
Yeah.
whatever cocaine facility, and you deliver it. Well, you could go back to your nightclub and you would still have 10 out of 10 in the nightclub. So okay. You could go and sell that there too. And it's constantly making this shit while you are playing GTA. So anytime you hop on, it's constantly making shit for you. Well, you can be playing with your buddies or doing whatever, and it can be doing that shit for you. So it's pretty dope, and you can run all of your businesses out of there. You know, obviously with some exclusions, but that's the number one way to make money. So I think our little crew all of us need to get our own nightclub and start making our own fucking kingpin.
Yeah, I was about to say, heck, I might need to get into this thing. Because I usually only get money from, you know, the big promotional events or from... Well, I would say our heist, but we only get like 70 to like 200,000 each time we play, so that's not really worth it.
It's definitely something that you should look into if you want to be the next Walter White, but more on him later. Wink, wink.
Oh yeah.
LOL. But. But yeah, so that's a great way to make money. Buy a fucking nightclub and watch YouTube videos on how to make the most money out of your nightclub, because that is how you are going to make the most money in GTA 5.
Get yourself a little Superman bike.
Oh, yeah, I get that, too. You can do that nightclub shit so much faster if you do have an oppressor bike. It's dope. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I would highly recommend that. But there is one more thing I want to talk about with GTA, and I did some research for GTA 6.
Oh, gosh. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So it's real sketchy to do research on GTA 6 because a lot of 11-year-olds out there are trying to get million-viewed videos.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I've definitely gotten clickbaited by some of them.
Yeah, yeah, and I was pretty nervous about it, but, you know, I found a video that seemed pretty legit, so, it's Gamia, the YouTube channel that I got this stuff from. So okay. Look up Gamia for his credibility if you'd like. But it seemed pretty legit. It wasn't anything like too far out there.
Yeah, you and always gotta be a little skeptical.
Yeah, no, and these are all rumors and leaks. There's nothing like confirmed. Obviously, Rockstar's really hush hush with everything.
Oh yeah.
So these are just kind of rumors and leaks in quotation marks. So. And most of this information is for the story mode of GTA 6, so I'm guessing online won't be too different, but
yeah, I think they're usually pretty similar.
Yeah, for the most part. So, again, this is all according to Gamia YouTube channel, and basically GTA 6 has been in production since 2014, and... Okay. GTA 5 came out, what, 2012 or some shit like that?
Probably, yeah, but it's like, I mean, they probably haven't worked on it just because they're making so much from GTA 5, you know? It's like one of the most played games, you know, in the
of
decade
all time.
Or whatever from, yeah,
no,
probably the
all time.
Oh, yeah, no,
in
it's
the
dumb.
Decade, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and Red Dead 2 came out.
Oh, yeah. Knocking it out of the park.
Yeah, so apparently they're doing updates to GTA 5 online. They released Red Dead 2, and now they're getting ready to release GTA 6. So Rockstar is a very, very busy company.
Okay. How old is this video you found?
It came out in January of this year, 2020.
Okay, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I mean, you can go out there, guys, and you can find thousands of videos of GTA 6 things, so don't just go look at anything, but... This information seems pretty legit, but yeah, it's been in production since 2014. As far as the release date goes, an Australian video game retailer named Gameware listed GTA 6 coming out in 2020. These Gameware people have been right before with game release dates, such as the Devil May Cry game and the Need for Speed game.
Okay.
And plus, it takes about 7 to 8 years for Rockstars to pump out a new title, so that would that would work out pretty well.
They do spend quite a bit of time on their stuff.
Yeah.
It's always really
yeah.
nice.
Red Dead was released, what, 2 years ago, maybe? Or a year and a half ago?
Yeah,
so
I hope
it's not 7 to 8 years from
yeah, I know.
Red Dead 2. But yeah, so this company's been right before about release dates. So that's just kind of all we got to go off. Some people say 2021 as well or 2022. But the big reason why I think a lot of people could expect it to come out this year is the game is only going to be on next-gen consoles for it to be on the most powerful hardware. So people think that GTA 6 is going to be released around the same time as the new PlayStation and Xbox, which is this year, 2020.
Oh, really? I don't remember seeing, you know, we did the, I guess I did the little Xbox release thing a couple weeks ago, I think it was around winter, right? Is that when GTA says it's supposed to come out too?
Yeah.
Around winter time? Yeah.
Well, yeah, I think it just says 2020. But,
okay.
Yeah, so, I mean, that makes sense to me, where Sony releases their PlayStation, Microsoft releases their Xbox right around the same time.
Oh, yeah, they have to for the competition
is
and
releasing.
All that. But...
right around the same time GTA 6 that could is be coming good. Out.
Yeah, so then when you buy the new system, you know, first game can be GTA 6.
Yeah.
It seems like a good marketing idea.
Yeah. I tell you what, though. Oh, I bet you it's going to be straight up ass, at least the online, for a while.
Yeah, Red Dead Online, I know they've done a lot to it. Like, me and my friends have played it a bit, and it's not too bad. But it does kind of get stale after a while. And I know when they first dropped it, it was like, I don't know. The way they did it is they kind of made it so they made the foundation and then they slowly added stuff on over time. You know, they're building on it and it's kind of a sketch situation. A lot of people got turned off by the whole idea that it wasn't actually complete. And it's still kind of, I don't know. They definitely have not tried as hard as GTA 5. You know, GTA 5 is pretty cared after, you know, looked after, cared for, all that.
Well, that's their baby. That's their moneymaker.
Yeah, I know. Exactly.
Well, and plus, I was just more talking about, like, right when it comes out, I'm sure it's going to be super laggy and you're going to get kicked and it's going to take forever to get into a session.
Oh,
and
God. Yeah, the amount of people. Yeah.
Yeah, and just it being brand new servers and things like that. So,
yeah, I'll have to touch on that later. But
yeah, no, for sure. Also, like, I know with Red Dead, they didn't release online right away, which was kind of nice. Like, they wanted to make sure that they had at least something.
Yeah, yeah.
Completed by the time they got rid of it, so that was cool. So if they want to take their time with that, that's the thing with Rockstar. If they want to take their time, go ahead.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're the one company that really does take a lot of time to make their game. Not perfect, but, you know, they really do clean it up quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, not even that, but they just make a good game to begin with. You
know
what I mean?
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
And just the amount of detail and attention that they put into GTA, well, Red Dead 2 Online, or Red Dead 2, the
storyline.
In the storyline. Yeah. Which brings me to my next point with GTA 6. The map is supposed to be bigger than Red Dead Redemption 2.
Was Red Dead's bigger than GTA 5?
Red Dead was like six times bigger than GTA 5.
Fuck off. No way. I know it was a pain in the ass to get to one set. Actually, now that you say that. Yeah, no, it probably took like 15 to 20 minutes to get from one side to the other.
I think it took about 45 minutes to get from one side to the other. Bro, they included the old map from Red Dead and then the whole entire new one from Red Dead 2.
Oh, that's... Yeah. Yeah, no, that's right.
It's a fucking huge-ass map, and this one for GTA 6 is supposed to be even bigger. So, and there's supposed to be, like, a main island, and then there's going to be, like, a secondary island, and then, like, a bunch of little baby islands, like the Cuba or Caribbean islands, things like that.
Okay.
That you can go to.
That could be cool.
Yeah, and they might return to Vice City. Vice City is an old Grand Theft Auto game.
I think
which
GTA
is,
4. Or no, G. I don't
yeah,
even fucking
it was
know. It's like
literally
two,
its own game.
Something.
It's literally called GTA Vice City.
Never mind. Yeah, I remember playing that in high school on my laptop.
Yeah.
Oh, that was great.
Which, that one takes place in Miami, I believe. So.
Okay.
So it might return to Vice City. Rockstar apparently reached out to a Florida school or a Florida store. I couldn't really hear what the YouTube guy said.
I hope not a school.
Yeah, I don't think so either, but you know, I don't want to be wrong. But it was to scout out the premises for it to be like to throw in some real Miami memorabilia in there.
Yeah.
And they want bits and pieces from other maps as well, so like the Liberty City map and the GTA 5 map and stuff like that. Like, they just want to throw bits and pieces in this. So it's a big combination of all the maps that they've done.
Wow. Okay.
And then some. And they also really want to stress, like, the Miami culture and the Caribbean culture, Cuba culture, and, you know, cocaine is real big in those areas.
Hell
so,
yeah.
That should be a big part of it, too. But the environment changes, like, in Red Dead 2. You should see hurricanes, floods, lightning strikes, all sorts of shit going on, to where in story mode it's going to close other parts of the map. And
I feel like we've seen stuff like that in other games.
Or well, and Rockstar's done that too. Like, I remember you couldn't cross this one bridge until later in the game because of the weather or some shit like that.
Okay.
Yep.
Huh.
Yeah. No. So, and there's also going to be the like the wear and tear in the world and on your character, like how Red Dead was, where you see.
Oh yeah.
You know, their bodies change and the environment change over time.
I like that. Yeah. Yeah. And then you had like the natural hair growth and all that. That was really cool.
Yep. That was pretty cool.
Take
so,
your hat to the barber.
Yep. Yeah. And apparently it takes place in the past in the 1970s and 80s. Like this was like.
Okay. That should be interesting.
Pablo Escobar was fucking huge, I believe.
Yeah.
So there's going to be lots of drug running, I'm guessing, in this one. The gameplay should be similar. I don't think Rockstar wants to fix or change anything really. Cause
yeah, I don't know if there's too much
the
to
gameplay.
Fix.
The gameplay feels really good. They just want to fine tune some more things. But they might change the shooting a little bit because the shooting is pretty bad in GTA.
Yeah, it's just kind of
the
you know,
auto lock on and going in the wrong cover and things like that.
Yeah, it's a little fucked up.
Yeah, no, so hopefully they fine-tune that, but also the weather should have a bigger impact on the game as well. Like, in GTA Online, when it rains, the roads get a little slippery, and that's about it.
Oh,
so.
God. I can see that getting dangerous. I can hardly drive as it is.
Yeah, yeah, oh, I can't imagine what it would be like to fly my oppressor in a hurricane. So.
Oh, I thought you were about to say, yeah, fly it on the wet roads. It's like, fuck you, you asshole.
Yeah.
Stuck in my sports car, my wheels just fucking spinning. Like, hey.
Yeah, but and then finally the last point I have for GTA 6 is supposedly it's going to be an AK.
Oh, shit. Okay.
For those of us that have 8K TVs, that would be an amazing thing to play.
Too bad those things are running like $1,000.
Yeah, well, my dad bought my mom a smart TV when it was $1,000. Now you can buy, like, a smart TV for, like, $150, so.
Damn. Okay.
Yeah, so just give her time, Bert. She'll come down. And then there's also red tracing in it, which gives you a little bit more details, I guess. And
yeah, it makes the, makes like, yeah, they do some really stupid, like, geometry with looking into mirrors and stuff, so it looks more realistic. So then when you look in glass and all that stuff, it's supposed to be pretty cool. I have it on my laptop, and it definitely does look really nice on those games.
Yeah, no, so they're apparently having that in the next GTA game, so that would be sweet. And with the campaign, they're going to have multiple endings again.
Like that was so cool. Was. I love that so much.
Yeah, no, I think it's cool when games do that, so
yeah. Then I remember seeing something. They're like one of the guys, you know, gets a tattoo based on what the ending is or whatever, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Not to spoil anything, but yeah. You know, there's there's other effects other than you know, whatever. Yeah, yeah. It's their attention to detail is pretty impressive.
Oh yeah, and it's always been like that with all of their games.
Oh yeah.
So
yeah.
Should be another banger nonetheless, but moving on to the Xbox world, staying on to the Xbox world, Burger, or Bert, you're not fucking Burger, you don't get to hold that name, piece of shit. Do you want to kind of jump into this right here?
Oh, yeah. As we've mentioned in the past, you know, basically every time I name drop, you know, my beautiful co-host here, Burger, we do play quite a bit of Xbox and all that. You know, we play GTA 5 on the Xbox and all that, and we usually play games off of the Gamepass. Yeah, off of the Gamepass. Yeah. Lately, we've been trying to finish up some games. You know, we're playing them in Legendary mode and all that, playing the campaign, like playing Halo and Gears of War currently. But we've also, you know, beaten Outlast. We play Overcooked when we get fucking blasted over the weekend, which we're gonna have to start number two this weekend, I think.
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah, should be exciting. And then we had to take a break on Wildlands. Good old Ghost Recon Wildlands. That game was starting to give us some serious troubles. Oh my God, some missions were insane. It's like, yeah, actually, now that we, like earlier, you know, the whole weather affects the surroundings and all that. Like, there's this one stupid mission we were stuck on when you could only do it at nighttime. You remember mm-hmm. that? And you had to, like, go in and find the guy from Splinter Cell. And it's yeah. like, oh my God, you had to go
that
through
old
these guys.
Bastard.
You couldn't fucking kill anybody, and you had to sneak your way through this crazy Unidad base, and people are... whatever. It was fucking horrendous, but yeah.
Yeah, and then there's the time where we were just walking, and all of a sudden it was like, kill the Predator. Yeah. Like, oh.
Okay.
The hell he's doing. You might as well have told me that I had to kill Tom Brady for Madden at this point for how random it was.
Oh, it was so dumb.
Holy shit. But yeah, no, I mean, we both have the Game Pass on Xbox, and we are just, what we're trying to do is we're trying to go through these games
just
together.
Like some older games we played in our childhoods and all that, you know. And also just for the whole, you know, beating it on Legendary is pretty, it's pretty fun. Well, it's miserable.
Yeah,
but
it's fucking miserable and terrible, but it's yeah. a nice feeling at the end of the day. And we're doing it with the big games. So like what Bert was saying with Halo, like we beat the first Halo, which is one of the worst games I've ever played in my life. Halo 1
oh,
is ass. It is bad.
Yeah, but, the level design, the guns and everything. Oh God, it's
yeah.
bad.
Yeah, no, the voice acting and cinematography, of course, was awesome, and then the graphics with the updated version was beautiful, but other than that, gameplay, the guns, the level design, ass.
Oh, yeah.
So we beat Halo 1 for the first time, too, I would like to say.
Oh, yeah, yeah, we never, I think we started with 2 back in,
yep.
back in NOM.
Back when we were 6.
Yeah.
That's probably why we're so fucked up now.
Yeah, exactly.
We also beat the first Gears of War. That one was uh-huh. actually pretty cool. I've never even played Gears of War before.
Yeah, I played with all my friends in middle school and high school and all that. I love the series. I only mm-hmm. played like 2 and 3, I think, but
yeah, no, those ones are cool. And then as you guys have heard before, we've beaten Outlast together. That's one of my biggest accomplishments in life.
Oh, yeah. That game.
That game was tough.
I'm so excited for the new ones. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, those ones were tough as fuck. And then, yeah, we beat Overcooked. We beat that completely drunk as hell. We would just get really turnt and play Overcooked.
Yeah. I don't remember if we went into it, but it's kind of like the old browser games, you know, where you get the orders up on the top of the screen and then you have to make a burger, you know, it's like burger, lettuce, onion, bun, whatever.
Yeah.
And you have to like get so many, well, you know, of course, cause Burger and I are completionists, you know, we have to get 3 stars on every level. So doing yep. it drunk, we would just be there totally plastered. Like, come on, we can do it. Just restarting
yeah.
the level and going back.
Yeah.
In.
Yeah, no, and it involves so much teamwork, and then the levels change, so you're slipping and falling on ice and jumping
oh,
into the fucking lava. And
yeah, you're in hell
you
trying to jump around platforms and shit.
You're in hell, that's right, I forgot
it was
about
very
that.
Fitting. Yeah, no, it was miserable.
Yeah. Yeah, no, but we ended up beating that, so we're going to start Overcooked 2, and that's one thing Bert and I were kind of talking about. We would love to start a stream someday. Where you guys can watch us play. Yeah, so if this thing ever takes off, yeah, if you want to see us drunk as fuck cooking hamburgers on a video game, not in real life, you know, that's a fire hazard, Bert. We don't want to murder anybody.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, not intentionally.
Yeah, we don't want to, you know, do our best Hitler impression. But anyways,
yeah.
Yeah, that's what we like to do, though, is, like, just go on the Game Pass, find some real famous games, and try to beat them together. So as more stories come up from our Game Pass adventures, we will be sure to let you fellas know.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, so...
Holy shit, we're getting pretty deep in the fucking show.
Yeah. Boy, this one's going by real smooth.
Time flies and you're having fun. Yeah.
Yeah, what else you got for us today, Bert?
Yeah, so I was going through Twitter this week, and I ended up seeing, you know, I wasn't looking for a story, of course. I'm off that train. But
good.
Yeah. Yeah. But one thing I know that at least we used to be pretty into for TV shows was The Walking Dead, and I heard that's coming back this weekend.
Yep.
Yeah.
I heard that too when you told me.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I've been keeping up with it. I think I have one or two episodes left. For some reason, I haven't gotten around to watching them. I always forget about it. But I know that, I don't know. I think that a lot of people used to watch it and all during... Holy shit.
Doring.
The beginning of the show is really popular, you know?
It was huge.
And they've just kind of... It's just tapered off a lot. I think you stopped watching the last season, didn't you?
I'm trying so hard to finish up season 9 because I just wanted to see... Well, I guess it's not really a spoiler anymore at this point when Rick died.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I really wanted to see how that goes because he was always my favorite character and everything. And now I'm just trying to finish up season 9 because it's halfway done for me. And I'm like, fuck, I might as well just finish it up and then be done with it forever. But yeah, no, I love that show. I thought it was so amazing and so cool. And it's just not the fucking same show anymore. So, yep, I'm done with that show.
Yeah, because I know they had the whole, I don't know if it was a spoiler or some sort of a little teaser or whatever, but, you know, you always mention it that, you know, you stuck around for Rick, but they're bringing a movie around or something for him. I never got into him. But
yeah, he's my boy.
Yeah, I know. I love Negan, you know, as we touched on last week. He's my favorite. But
yeah, no, I can't remember who won that fight again between those two.
Actually, you know, if you tally up all the points, I think Negan might have a couple more than Rick. But
yeah,
but overall,
Rick, how did that go? He like stabbed Negan with a plate or something like that.
Yeah,
he
got him in the neck. I think he got him in the neck, and then he ended up not going too deep, and then he like bandaged him up or something, and then everybody's like, "What the fuck are you doing, dude?"
Mm-hmm.
Then everyone's like, "Well, we're gonna have to off Rick into sleep now because he will at Negan Niv." And I'm like, "Guys, please." I'm like the biggest pacifist of all time, and like when I saw that shit start to happen in the show when people were turning on Rick, I was having a mental breakdown. There's no better way to put it. I was freaking out. I'm like, "Guys, let's be adults here, okay? There's no need to do anything irrational. It's okay."
Yeah, he didn't kill somebody. Wow.
Yeah, I know.
Wasn't his like, was a big reason
that, but
wasn't his big reason? He's like, if I kill him, you know that I'm basically at the same level as him. We're not better than him. If
yeah,
we end up murdering him, so he's gonna be punished. Don't worry, but
yeah, yeah. I mean, he only has to sit in a cell for whatever
the rest of his life. Yeah.
Yeah, until he inevitably gets let out. But that's beside
the point. Where he just walks out the fucking cell door. Yeah. Literally, like, that's how he escapes. Just walks out.
Yeah, the whole show's so weird.
Yeah. No, it was so cool with Negan. It was so cool when he bashed Glenn's face in.
Oh, my God, yes.
I love Glenn, too, but I was like, that's pretty badass.
Shit, if you gotta go, it's better than just getting fucking bit and dying in a bed. That shit's lame.
Yeah. Yeah, so I really did like the show, but it's just not the same anymore, and they're bringing in a ton of new characters, and they're really, like, I don't care if shows bring in new characters, but...
Yeah, but then it starts to, like, dilute the main thing. You know, like, when you stick around for the characters and all that, but then they end up just cutting and adding new people in, it kind of takes away from, you know, what the show originally was.
Exactly. Yeah. No, so they're running it into the ground, and they definitely should have stopped when they were ahead, just like another TV show did. Do you remember what TV show that was that stopped while it was ahead?
Well, I know you always bring it up whenever I talk about it, but I'm in college now. Whenever I get out of class early or whatever, I end up coming back to my dorm and watching some Breaking Bad. I think that's what you're alluding to.
Yeah.
And that show, now I think I only really got into about like halfway through season 4 or so, But I think there's six seasons total, like 10 to 12 episodes per season. They're like an hour apiece.
Five seasons total.
I'm pretty sure it's six. Am I crazy?
No, Better Call Saul has six.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, nonetheless,
yeah,
it is a this show. It's insane. It's like I remember watching it before, and like it's just such a rich story-driven show that like I don't know. There's just so much that happens every episode. I mean, my memory isn't the best, but I still get caught by all these things that happen. It's like every episode, there's always something crazy going on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I mean, I've rewatched it twice now, and I have a friend that has watched it like five times all the way through. Oh, so I know it's 2020 and we're still talking about Breaking Bad, but it's a really good show, and anybody that likes good television needs to.
Oh, yeah.
Check out this show. It's just everything that you know, you could want in a show.
Yeah, so. Makes you think a little bit, you know. It's like, ah, what would I do in this situation? Like, there's so many, like, because at first, you know, I started to fucking hate the, you know, Walter's wife. I fucking hate that bitch.
Skyler.
I fucking hate that bitch so goddamn much.
I still hate her. She's a cunt.
But the second time going through, I'm like, if I was in her situation, like, I feel like, this is probably super lame, I feel like Breaking Bad has, like, enlightened my viewpoint. Like, it's really, like, I'm thinking through each character's perspective. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I feel like I'm on meth, dude. But, like, you really think about each character's perspective on the whole scenario, and I don't know, it's amazing. It's, I don't even know. I love that show so much.
Well, I mean, I totally understand Skylar being upset, but she's a cunt.
Yeah.
She was a fucking bitch.
She takes things a little bit far, but like.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Straight up bitch. I truly believe that Walter had good intentions.
Oh,
at
yeah.
the beginning.
Yeah.
He really, truly did. And then he just kind of got consumed in it with his greed and his pride and everything. So.
Yeah, that was the one thing I never really got. Like, you know, the whole thing would have been ended if he just, like, took his friend's money. You know, the Elliot.
Yeah.
Whatever. From
yeah,
the
Gretchen
Man
and Elliot.
Yeah, it's like,
well,
he's just so
he
prideful.
Was so bitter about that, though, because that was supposed to be
his endeavor. Yeah, like his, not invention, but, you know, he came up with the science behind it or whatever.
Yeah, Andy came up with the name, too,
yeah.
behind it. I can't remember why he didn't do it, though. He just sold his
I don't know
share
about
or something
that,
like that. Yeah,
I don't know about that part.
I remember. Well, it's not that big of a deal, but, yeah, he talks to Jesse about it, and you can still tell he's super bitter about it.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
like that. It's like the three guys that started Apple, Steve Jobs and the other guy I can't think of, but there's
yeah.
actually a third guy too.
And he kind
of
did
and
a
that
lot of
guy,
work.
The third guy sold the share, and now Apple's worth over $1 trillion.
Oh yeah, that was a big fuck up.
Yeah, yeah, no. So yeah, I would be a bit bitter about it too. But I mean, I still think at the end of the day, Walter still kept his family as his number one priority. I mean, I definitely think the greed and the pride and shit got way up
pushed
there.
Him to extremes, but
yeah, but you know, deep down in his heart, I think he really did care about his family the most.
Yeah.
So it's just a good show. And I just like how he's just a normal guy and it, you know, it's just an everyday show kind of a thing.
Oh yeah. Yeah. It really takes in the life of, you know, somebody who fucking cooks meth.
But I mean, it's just like a very like real story. Like,
oh
that
yeah
shit could,
and like the acting in
well
it too
happen.
Like, I feel like I couldn't feel the hatred towards Skylar, you know, if it was anybody else. It's like they do such a great job. It's like, oh god, I don't know, it's amazing.
Yeah, now she's just a cunt. But anyways, I think that's Anna Gunn or something like that. I think that's her name.
Probably. I think I remember seeing that scrolling through the credits.
I was waiting for you to say, no, it's Skylar White with fuck.
Yeah, what the heck?
I remember those fucking scenes were really gross in that movie. I didn't like that, like when Walter and Skyler were getting funky.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot of weird, you know, under-the-pants jerk-off sessions and shit.
Yeah.
Like, I just watched that earlier today of oh, God, what's her name? The sister-in-law or whatever. And then the
jerking Hank off in the hospital bed.
Yeah, I watched that earlier. That was fun.
She's like, I bet I can get it up. He's like, no, you can't.
Yeah, and then he, you know.
And then you see him in the wheelchair.
He's like, son of a bitch. But yeah, it's just like cute little subtleties like that just really make that show what it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. No, and yeah, I can't talk about Breaking Bad without talking about my boy, Saul Goodman.
Oh, yes. I'm excited to finish this up so I can go over to that again.
Oh, I have such a huge crush on that guy.
Yeah, even like, I don't know, I've seen the first two episodes, or maybe it's the first season and a half of Better Call Saul, and it's like just seeing his evolution from the beginning of that to Breaking Bad is insane.
Yeah,
I know there's probably a lot more through the Better Call Saul TV show, you know, that fills stuff in, but. Yeah,
absolutely. And I love Saul Goodman. He is probably one of the smartest guys in the Breaking Bad universe. Now, he's not smart.
He's
not smart. Like, yeah, he's not smart like Walter White, like book smart and shit like that. But he knows.
He's Better Call Saul.
Yeah, he knows the ins and outs of the law and just systems. And he can see systems. And unfortunately, he exploits them. For the negative on him,
fucking
not the positive. but, you know, what he's doing is very criminal, but very smart. And he knows how to, like, win people over, too. He's very charismatic and everything like that. And I love Saul. So that I love Better Call Saul. It's a great show. And I would highly recommend that if you are going to watch Better Call Saul. That you do watch Breaking Bad first, because even though Better Call Saul takes place well before Breaking Bad, there are a lot of characters that return.
Yeah, I also noticed there's kind of like some weird stories in Breaking Bad, you know, that actually end up playing out in Better Call Saul.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, a lot of characters that you see in Breaking Bad and Better Call Saul. So much so that season 5's coming out like next week. Like on TV.
Oh shit.
On TV, okay. Like on AMC. And apparently season 5 is going to have Hank Schrader and Steve Gomez in it.
Dang.
Yeah. No, that's huge.
That'll be cool.
That's huge that they have those two in there. They also renewed Better Call Saul for one more season. Season 6, so.
And they're on 5 now, then.
Yeah, right? This is going to be season 5, so.
So do they do it like Walking Dead, where they do the first half of the season, second half, or is this going to be like,
I don't know,
10 or 11 episodes?
I don't know, I've been watching everything on Netflix, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I think they usually release the next season once the new season comes out. You know, like 5 will drop at the start of 6 or whatever. But
yeah, for on Netflix, that's what they did for this time around, so. Yeah, no, I'm trying to get all caught up with Better Call Saul, because then I can actually watch it on TV and I can be like, shit, this is dope.
Yeah, this is why you buy cable. Baby.
Yeah, exactly. So those are our three favorite shows. I know there are a couple more shows that we like. Like I really enjoy Storage Wars.
Yes, so many good memes.
Yeah, no, and I know like you like Sons of Anarchy and
no, I could definitely make a list.
Yeah, things like that. Maybe we'll make a list. I'm not, if we do that though, first and foremost, I am not a big TV show guy. I definitely like movies more, so.
Yeah, I'm more of the other ways around. I like making those deep connections. I don't know, it's like sometimes after watching a really good TV show, I'll go look in the mirror and I'm like, who the fuck is this guy? It's kind of concerning.
I never really got big into TV shows, but
I love TV.
But yeah, we might have to go into that someday. But those are definitely our our favorites, and we've been big fans of them for a long time. So, anyways, wrapping up this show today, I have one more story I'd like to talk about, and I have another random history story thing.
Awesome.
Yeah, so I will just jump right into this, and then we can wrap up. Sounds good. The one that I have today is called Cleveland's Balloon Fest Becomes a Total Nightmare.
Okay.
Yeah, so this one is a banger, guys. So the United Way decided to hold a charity event in 1986 to help people in need. What they wanted to do was hold this big event to raise money, but at the same time, they also wanted to break the world record for most balloons launched at once. The old record was at Disneyland for like their 30th anniversary or something like that.
Okay.
So Cleveland, you know, the city of Cleveland really wanted to raise all this money and break a world record at the same time. So what they did is they got 2,500 volunteers to go into this room, blew balloons up, let them go, and they were caught in a net spread out across the ceiling.
Okay, that's good.
So, yeah, so they would all just kind of sit in, like, this huge gymnasium or something like that, and they would just, you know, put the balloon on a little helium pump, tighten it, and let go, and just keep doing that.
Okay.
Over and over again, to the point to where they had 1.5 million balloons.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, this sounds like fucking Up. That should be Disney.
Yeah.
Fucking house just lifts up.
The fucking gymnasium ceiling just comes unhinged.
Yeah.
And then a storm was coming.
God damn it.
The day they were supposed to release this. But they just let the balloons go before the storm got there.
Okay.
Yep, so they let the balloons go before the weather could rain on their parade.
There you go.
I'm just
getting prepared.
I'm just trying to think. They're like, shit, there's a storm coming. Hurry, let them go.
Yeah.
Like, what do they expect is going to happen? But, okay, I'll keep going.
Okay.
The storm still came. And it didn't affect the launch, but it still affected the situation after the launch. So I'm going to send you some pictures here, Bert, and we'll throw them up on the screen. Yeah. But go ahead and take a fucking look at that.
What the fuck am I looking at?
Those are boons.
That big, what's that big thing in the middle?
That's balloons. That's 1.5 million balloons.
No fucking way.
Look at the second picture. Look at that.
Holy fucking shit. It looks like a fucking gas bomb.
Yeah, I know. So if you guys are watching this on YouTube, you should be able to see those pictures right now.
Holy shit. But
it looks like the Empire State Building's getting swallowed by this big orange cloud.
Holy shit.
Yeah, so what goes up must go down. So all 1.5 million balloons landed all over the city of Cleveland.
No way. Oh my God.
This disaster ended up causing runways to shut down, like actual airports. To shut down, the Coast Guard had to shut down a search and rescue in Lake Erie because there were so many fucking balloons in the lake.
Oh, no.
And somehow this ended up killing two people, this whole balloon disaster. I don't know if it's talking about the search and rescue people.
Oh, God.
Because apparently they were looking for some fishermen in the lake.
Under like a sheet of 40 balloons.
sheet of 40, yeah, like 40 balloons deep, I hope you mean.
Yes. Yeah. You could probably walk on it, honestly. Holy fuck.
Yeah. Yeah, and then they ended up finding, like, the fishermen's bodies later, dad and the wife tried suing the fucking, the United Way for this shit, and they ended up settling for an undisclosed amount.
God damn.
All this shit. But yeah, but as you can tell, Cleveland is not the grenadest. Wow, yes. You can tell where my brain's going. We usually play Modern Warfare after this.
There you go.
Cleveland is not the greatest at promoting things. See Tencent Beer Night.
Oh no, they were the. Oh my God, it's the same.
Same
fucking
city. Yeah.
They're just like doing shit way too fucking big.
Yeah, no, Tencent Beer Night, guys. You'll have to tune in to episode 1 of the BurtnBurger show.
Oh, that's good.
To hear the story behind that, but Cleveland had a 10-cent beer night for one of their baseball games, and they also had this balloon disaster. I think this balloon disaster came after the 10-cent beer night. I think that like happened in the 70s, and this happened in the 80s. Oh my goodness. I can't imagine, like...
You just look up and it's fucking black.
Yeah, can you imagine, like, not knowing that's going on?
Oh, well, we're all gonna
die.
And
you just look outside. Are those fucking balloons?
Yeah.
But, you know, at least the balloons were biodegradable.
Oh,
so.
Okay. Yeah.
They thought ahead, I guess.
That's good.
Yeah, seriously. So that is the Cleveland's Balloon Fest becomes a total nightmare. I feel like I saw this video the other day on iFunny where this computer accidentally set off every firework.
Oh
at a
my
firework
God,
show.
I saw that too. It looked like a fucking mushroom cloud.
Mushroom cloud, yeah. No, looked like I would be scared.
Oh yes. Honestly. The people were just sitting there, you know, leaning back in their fucking camping chairs, like
yeah, it's fucking good show. Holy yes. Shit.
Some people were running.
People in the comments were saying that's how more fireworks shows should go. They just last 10 seconds. And
holy shit.
Yeah, no, but I think that firework would scare me. So I think if I saw a million and a half balloons just go off like that, yeah, I'd get spooked.
There's actually, like, honestly, probably enough to fucking block out the sky for, like, anybody who's standing right underneath them. That's insane.
Yeah. No. I thought when balloons, when they went high enough, they would just pop.
Yeah, from the pressure, but it's probably pretty high, I would imagine.
Yeah, so, like, why didn't they, like, what, why did they start going down? Like, did they blow them up with their air from their lungs and just fucking whip them as far as they could or something? Like,
maybe.
I don't know.
I have no fucking clue.
You know, I am always like, you know, at a zoo or something, you'll see a balloon just float away.
Yeah.
And you know, you just watch it and it goes pretty high and it'll just pop on its own. Like, I don't understand why that didn't happen here, but yeah. I don't, maybe it's because one balloon would try to reach the top, but, you know, it was too fucking busy getting butt fucked by 1,499,999 balloons.
They were just pushing themselves up. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. They should have tried. I wonder how they like released it. I wonder if they like
they probably just took the net outside and just
they probably
Steve,
just cut the ceiling. Just cut the ceiling off the gym.
Yeah. Yeah, it just opened up.
Oh, my goodness. But, yeah. So, anyways, that's the history story I got for you guys. Is there anything else you wanted to touch up on?
Oh, gosh. No, I think I'm good.
Did you have something that you wanted to talk about? What's happening this weekend? If you can touch on that real fast.
Oh, yeah. So, we're actually hanging out this weekend, mm-hmm. as far as I know. So, yeah. Yeah, well, I went out to the liquor store in the bad part of town. You know, I was fucking terrified. And, of course, I'm like, I'm pretty young, you know, just got my license and all that, so that was fun picking up our boozies.
Yeah, I thought you were thinking like someone's gonna want to fuck you or something.
Yeah, that too. You never know. Yeah, there's some sketchy people going in and out of them.
What'd you get us?
Oh, just your peach schnapps, and then I like rum quite a bit, and I ended up getting some black spiced rum.
Ooh,
and okay. I ended up trying some before the show just to kind of loosen myself up a little bit. And it's like fucking 50%. Like, if you smell this shit, it fucking, like, it curls your toes, as you would say.
Yeah, you get a little buzz just off of sniffing her.
Yes, it was fucking bad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. Don't call it my peach schnapps, though. That makes me sound kind of gay.
Yeah, I know. I was thinking about it. Like, I'm like, oh, God, Burger. How exactly am I going to go into the store?
Yeah, notice I told you to get it. Like, hey.
Yeah, I'm like, God damn it.
Yeah.
I felt so... Like, I went up to the counter because I couldn't fucking find it. And I'm like, hey, you guys have any peach schnapps? And he's like...
He just whipped
his
cock out.
Yeah, how much do you want? Yeah, exactly. Oh, you're gay. So it's like, yeah. As we talked about last episode, yeah, I'm probably gay. So I guess it was best for me to do. Mm-hmm. And, so I go in there, and he's like, yeah, so how much do you want? And I'm like, I don't know. And I already had the fucking... I don't think it was a fifth. It's quite a bit of fucking rum I bought.
You're like,
and
this much? I'm like, holding.
Yeah, exactly. I had this thing of rum. It's probably like fucking 30 ounces or some shit. Mm-hmm. And he's like, yeah, are you sure you want that much peach schnapps? And him and this other guy are just looking at me laughing. I'm like,
They're licking their lips.
Maybe I'll go for a pint. And he's like, yeah, that sounds better. And I'm like, hey, thanks.
Yeah, no, I mean, I'm big into mixing drinks. Every time Bert comes over, I'm always making him drinks, and I roofie him, and then I fuck him in the ass hard.
I always wonder why I wake up and I don't remember anything.
I always wonder why my asshole's gaping when I wake up.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I really like making drinks, and this one girl was talking to me, and she told me this drink she liked, and it had peach schnapps in it. I'm like, fuck, okay, this is like the 80th drink that I have seen that has peach schnapps in it, so I'll just get it. And then her and I ended up stopped talking, so I guess me and you were going to have sex in the driveway, Bert.
Yeah.
I was supposed to make her a sex in the driveway, but, you know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the name of the drink, so.
Okay. Yeah, I ended up looking it up, and it looks like there's a lot of like, you know, I kind of like my fruity drinks and all that, so.
Yeah, I mean, because you're gay, but, you know, I really like them, too, so.
Yeah.
No, we're not your moonshine sippers or whiskey suckers. We're peach schnapps fuckers, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. For sure.
Yeah. So yeah, no, hopefully we'll get real turnt this weekend.
Have some good stories for you guys next week.
Yeah, we'll definitely have to tell you what goes on. So thank you guys so much for listening to this episode of the BurtnBurger Show. We're on episode 5 now of the show. So that's kind of why we wanted to put the audiograms in there, kind of celebrate our 5th anniversary. No, but, you know, audiograms are pretty easy to throw together, so we wanted to look a little bit more professional. So that is all we have for you guys today. If you guys want to show us your artwork, go ahead and email us at burtnburger@gmail.com or send us a message on Twitter @BurtnBurger, and we'll definitely check those out. And if we do like your artwork, what the image you draw of me will go by the audiogram, and same with Bert. And and your artwork will be in every episode, and we'll definitely shout you guys out if that's something that you want to. So, and we might be able to work with you in the future to make some more shit for us too. So, many will enter, few will win. So
exactly, yeah. And all it really needs to be is like the, you know, probably like 128x128 or whatever. You know, I do a lot of the.
Mm-hmm.
The drawings and stuff for this, so anything like that, and then I'll just end up editing it in over the audiogram. So
yeah absolutely. And it can be any kind of image, even if that includes Bert with a nice sanitized finger in his urethra. So
Yeah.
Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this episode of the BurtnBurger Show. We will see you in the next episode, guys. Take care.
Oh, yeah. It's been real.